ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम अज्ञानतिमिरंदस्य से ज्ञानंजनाशलाकाय चक्षुरुन्मीलितमेन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। सो हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू नो अबाउट श्रीला जीव गोस्वामीज अर्ली पार्ट ऑफ लाइफ, हाउ ही वाज ब्रॉट अप एंड how did he learn and then what happened? Anybody here? Okay, yes, Rakshita Mataji.
Prabhuji, I don't know much, but I just know a little bit that he was Raghunath, Sanatan Goswami's and Raghunath Das Goswami's nephew. He was their elder brother's son. And his guru was, I think, Srila Raghunath Das Goswami. And he learned scriptures from them. And then I remember one pastime which Ratasha Mataji recently shared, that one time I think Raghunath Das Goswami wrote something and some other saint actually said that there, this shouldn't be like this, a mistake there. So he actually went and said on behalf, you know, for his guru, that it's not wrong, it's right. So his guru actually chastised him and said that you should leave Vrindavan. And he's a very and he learned, I think, from him. So that's all I know.
Okay, thank you, Rakshita Mataji, for sharing. Now, when you said Raghunath, just change it with Roop Goswami. So Roop Goswami, Sanatan Goswami,
Roop Goswami,
brother, and their nephew is Jeev Goswami. And he took initiation from Roop Goswami. So that's correct. Very nice. Actually, we don't know much about his early life. So we know that he is nephew of Roop Goswami and Sanatan Goswami. And then we know that he was the, his father's name was, what was his father's name? Can anybody tell?
Prabhuji, Vallabh.
Yeah, Vallabh. And what other, one more name? Anupam. Okay, Vallabh and Anupam were the names of his father. And then, of course, his father, he left very early. Early means Jeev Goswami was very, very small when his father, he passed away. And Jeev Goswami was, from his childhood, he was very attached to the Lord, through the deities. He was always, even while sleeping, he will have deities with him. That is how he will sleep with the Lord. And very much from the early childhood, very much devoted. So we don't know much, but we know that he was so much devotional in his early childhood. He actually went to have the whole tour of Navdweep by Nityananda Prabhu. Nityananda Prabhu actually toured him, introduced him to various Vaishnavas. And then he was asked to go to, where did Nityananda Prabhu ask him to go to? Who will tell? Nityananda Prabhu asked him, yes, correct.
Puri Banaras.
Nityananda Prabhu asked him to go to Vrindavan. So while on the journey to Vrindavan, he stopped at Banaras, and there he stayed for how long? Jeev Goswami? He stayed for 1 year. So he stayed there for 1 year. And there are six schools of Indian philosophy. Indian philosophic science of the Vedic science is understood in six, which is called as six systems of philosophy. Now, to learn even one system of philosophy, it actually takes very long time. It can take years to learn just one system of philosophy, many, many years. Jeev Goswami stayed there for 1 year, and in that 1 year, he mastered all the six systems of philosophies. Can anybody tell names of the six systems of philosophy? What are the names? Who will tell?
Nyaya, Sankhya, Vedanta,
Mimasa.
Mimamsa, yes. Very good. So Vedanta, Nyaya, Sankhya, Mimamsa, two are remaining. Who will tell? Anybody? So he mastered the six systems of philosophies, and Prabhupada writes in the first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam that I think it's probably the third chapter. Somewhere he writes that each of the devotees should be able to, each of the devotee who sits on the Vyasasan should be able to refute all the six systems of philosophies. We don't even know the name of the six systems of philosophy, what to say of refuting it. So four you already said, Vedanta, Nyaya, Sankhya, and Mimamsa. Two remaining. So one of them is yoga, right? Morning, everybody, you know, can see that people would like to do yoga these days in the morning. So yoga. And then sixth is Vaisheshika. Vaisheshika. So these are the six systems of philosophy. So he mastered all of them. And then he went on to his journey to Vrindavan. Once he was in Vrindavan, what did he do? When he reached Vrindavan, he was doing menial service for his uncles, Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami. He took shelter of them. And then sometimes he will be fanning them, you know. So they will do their work. They were writing and they were doing all the other things. And what was he doing? He was just simply fanning them. He will prepare. So writing in those days was not like this. Now we can just take a computer and write. In those days, they had to prepare leaves. They had special types of leaves or bark of tree, which they will prepare nicely. They will prepare ink from the trees and leaves and other places. Yes, yes, chalkboard bhi use karte hain pehle ke time pe. But this is, we are talking about 500 years ago, long time back. At that time, people used to have like bark of tree or leaves in which they used to write. So he used to prepare all those things. For each page, you need a lot of preparation to be done. So if people would not have, today, anybody can write anything, any nonsense, anywhere, because it's so easy. But previously, people only had important things which they will write, and not so much nonsense, because so much effort has to be put in. So like that, he was working very, very hard under Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami. So Jeev Goswami actually is extraordinarily brilliant. You already know one of the pastimes which Raksha Mataji was telling. We'll come to that. But he's so extraordinarily brilliant. I want to show you a couple of small sections of a beautiful seminar which Radhika Raman Prabhu did. And basically, Radhika Raman Prabhu is a PhD from Oxford University. And he did his PhD on a part of the chapter of Jeev Goswami on his work. So he is telling some things about Jeev Goswami. So let's hear this. Is it okay if I play?
Yes, Prabhuji.